All right, now we're gonna be talking about time controls in After Effects. So what I'm gonna do is take my project and kind of rearrange the workspace here and focus on these time controls. There is a time control tab here, and basically these buttons are for previewing your composition. This button over here is the basic RAM preview button. If you click it, it's going to start rendering your project from the very beginning all the way to the end. And what you may want to do, especially if your system is running a little slow, is change the resolution from full to a half or a third or a quarter. What I'm going to do is bring it down to all the way down to a quarter so we can see this a little faster. And what's going to happen here is After Effects will automatically look at the settings I have in my composition window and render the composition at quarter resolution. So let's start this RAM preview. It's moving a little faster than it was previously. And that's probably good enough. Let's see what that looks like. So you can also change the preview settings from the time control window. Instead of looking at the composition resolution settings, what you can do is change the resolution here. If it is set to auto, like I said, it will just look at the composition window settings and use those. You can change your RAM preview settings to a quarter and then have your composition window settings to full. That way, all of your work is previewed here at full resolution. But when you preview your footage, it will preview that footage at a quarter of the resolution. So those are going to be some useful tricks, time-saving tricks. Also, in the time controls, you have this loop button. You can change the RAM preview to play in a loop, which is the way we had it set before. You can have it set to play once and then play backwards from that. You can also have it set to play through only once and then stop. And yeah, you can also change the frame rate here in the time controls. And those are the buttons that I use the most, really. I don't use much of these at all because I just like to preview. I pretty much don't like to play around with these guys because I can just use keyboard shortcuts for those. So if you're familiar with the RAM preview button and the playback options here, that will get you started.